most ancient texts, including the very popular Kalchakra Tantra, Tibetan Zhang Zung culture scripts, etc., have mentioned the mysterious paradise of Shambhala. This word is Sanskrit originated and means the peaceful place or place of silence. According to the great legends, the place is accessible to only people having pure heart. The principle of love and wisdom govern the city and the people are free from suffering and all worries. The place is labeled with so many names that it is often regarded as land of thousand names. Some of the names delegates to this mysterious paradise are the land of water, land of radiant spirits, land of gods, the forbidden land, and many more. Hindus commonly refer to this place as the Aryavart, which means land of worthy ones. The Chinese call this as the High Time, meaning the western paradise of Hai Wang Mu, and the Russian calls this place as the Below Void. Despite of so many names, Shambhala or Shangri-La are the most popular names for the land of paradise. The origin of this land, or we can say the thought of the existence of this land, can be traced back to the ancient scriptures. As per the Hindu text, Shambhala is the place where God Kalki, the last avatar of Lord Vishnu, will born. According to the Hindu scriptures, Shambhala will guide the way to the new era of mankind. Shambhala is mentioned in the Buddhist text as well. It is an adaptation from the Hindu scriptures itself. Kalchakra remains as the former source where Shambhala was described at first. Kalchakra is regarded widely in Tibetan Buddhism. It is believed that the Shakyamuni Buddha taught Kalchakra as per the request of the king Suchandra. The idea of Shambhala is no different than the other teachings and has inner, outer, and alternative meanings as well. The ideology that only people having good heart and soul can reach this place reflects the outer meaning. In comparison, a healthier and peaceful state of mind and body refer to the inner meaning. Similarly, the meditative practice to achieve it is the alternative meaning. While people with special affiliation may be able to go there with a special affiliation, however, we cannot relate Shambhala to a physical place which can explore and find. One cannot arrive there unless they have attained the merit with their actual karmic association. Tibetan culture is deeply influenced and holds strong relevance for the teachings about Shambhala. The prophecy states that humankind will gradually degrade due to their materialistic obsessions. Finally, nothing will be left to conquer by the barbarians under the rule of the evil king. Then, finally, the time would arrive and the gates of Shambhala would unveil. It is believed that the evil king could attack the kingdom of Shambhala, and the king of the peaceful kingdom of Shambhala would then defeat all the evil and dark forces to guide us all to the golden age. Many people from the past claim that they were able to reach the land of paradise. However, they could not pinpoint the exact location of the map. The approximate location pinpointed by these achievers is believed to be across the mountains of Eurasia. The scriptures hold a different view. According to the Zhongzang scripts, Shambhala is located at the Satluj Valley in Himachal Pradesh, India. While the Mongolian text states the location to be in the valley of Siberia. As per the Altai Folklore Mountain, Belukha in Siberia has the gateway to reach Shambhala. Summing it all, the exact location of this world of paradise remains a mystery to humankind. Probably, it's actually the place lying on the edge of the physical world and maybe is the bridge to the world beyond. Thank you so much guys for watching this video. If you like it, like, comment and subscribe if you haven't already.